Okay, I ask everyone of us to stand. We're gonna talk about highlights in communion. I request also, Sir Joanna, flash all the clock of communion. So there is a folder that just said communion there, and it will come out. Maybe to stand up to the line of the offering. So, I'm gonna go through every communion track. Every one of you is a desire to have for your personal devotion to the Lord. So, I'm gonna give you instructions for your personal, but not just personal, but also for your family and ministry in the church, to your brethren. You have an obligation to God from yourself. You have an obligation to God, from yourself, to your family, and to your brethren, and to the rest of the world. That's the essence of the Song of Rainbow. Okay, so, if when you take communion, all the clocks of communion will come out. Just clap it there. Go to any folder then, in the desktop, then search communion at the side. It will start. No. It's just black. I did that already. So I did that yesterday. So that's it's not maybe another one can help. Okay, let's all open our Bibles. Put your arms around the children. Let's read. So everyone should read, and even the children should read. Let's read the essence of communion. Let's open in Revelation. Chapter 3. Now tell me the verse. Look for the verse. Stop with him. Stop with him. So I want us to interact with each other by actively looking for the verse. All of you, even your children, look at them together. Verse 320. So everyone go to 320. Just take the word communion. That no more days. Just remove the year. All communion will come out. If any man hear my voice, open the door. Nothing. You stop with him and give him. Everyone read together. Tell your put your alarm around your children and let them read it also aloud. Right now, read them aloud, later you can read them by whisper. Okay, together now. Behold.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock.
Everyone,
hear my voice and open the door. I will come home to him and will stop with him and be with me.
Everyone say, stop with him.
Stop with him.
That is communion. Stop with him and he with me. Similar to I am in the Father and the Father in me. Jesus Christ has communion with the Father and Jesus Christ will have communion with us in the Spirit. And that's the verse. Let's go to John chapter 17 verse 21. This is the fulfillment of that verse. Could you help out Sister Geraldine? Set communion at desktop folder. Click one folder. Okay. John 17:21. Are you all ready? Say amen. Okay. Now, I'm gonna let Sister Marisa read to the microphone. Every one of you follow suit. Enjoying your child to read alongside together with you. So Sister, tell the child the verse in the Bible. Read together with her. Okay? Let's do this. Continuously. Okay, go. 21. I'm gonna ask Brother Gabor to read it aloud. Okay. So every one of you read alongside Brother Gabor.
Thou Father, as in me,
everyone in the land,
I that they also may be one with us, that thou art with me, that thou art sent
me. Being one with God is communing with God, and being one with Jesus Christ is communing with Christ. The Holy Spirit fills you if you continuously have communion. If you don't continuously have communion, the Spirit has not yet filled you. So let's close our eyes. Raise your hand. Always put your arms around your child. Always teach them to close their eyes. You can look at their eyes if their eyes are open. You can cover their eyes if their eyes are open. And you can whisper to them also, to pray also alongside with it. So every one of us close our eyes, raise our hands to God. Hallelujah! We praise you, O God, today and forevermore. Thank you for the blessings you have given us. Thank you for all the word for our salvation. Lord, give us contrition in our hearts if we ever falter in worshiping thee, praising thee. If we ever falter in communion, give us this day our daily bread. And not just this day, every day now of our lives, use us, Lord, for thy glory. Use each and everyone here as your servant in the progressive ministry of the world. Anoint them, activate them, spark them, provoke them into service, into ministry, to train up their children, to admonish one another in this church, to grow in the grace and truth of your word, especially in the last days. Cleanse us and make us worthy to carry the word this morning and every day of our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's give God a big, a glowing, a clap offering. Let's shout right now. Let's give God a shout offering. What will you shout to God? Don't be ashamed. Shout it right now before you take our seat. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord, everyone. Shout continuously. Clap continuously. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! Okay, everyone take it. And you're home. I'm going to give you instructions. So, you just go to desktop, then type communion at the church. No more number, no more years. So all the communion tracks will be displayed. Okay. You don't just praise God in church service. You praise God at home. So when you have your family devotion, you have to teach also your children how to praise God. Look at your children. They're so bored about the world. Maybe they have been left alone during break time and other times. There is no offensive training of the children. But I'm just talking about the family devotional time. You can ask your child to lead in music, in praising God. Even if there's just few of you, you can teach them to clap their hands, to raise their hands. You can even, if they're just like robots, following orders, hypocrites, like, say, praise the Lord, say, I love you, God. That's the way to train a child. When he grows up, he will praise the Lord by himself, herself. But if you will not do it because you want them to voluntarily do it, they would not if you, they have been corrupted already in the world. Corruption comes from ordinary school. Those are not taking home schools. Corruption comes from idle time. So I'm giving an advice right now. I'm giving an advice that each and every one of us should offensively, let me say, to say, you take charge, you do something. Offensively, actively, prioritize training your children what to do. Let's read. This is exhortation. Let's open our Bible. Proverbs 29:15. Just for whatever you read right now or hear, you should admonish it to each other. This is how the church grew. So, right now, let's practice. And let's do that continuously, even after we have gone from this place. Ask your children to read. So Sister Marie, you're the one who opened it up. You're the one holding. You should be the one holding the Bible. You should be the one holding, even opening it up in his hand. You just put your arms around him so you'll be near to him. Then you ask him to read to your ear. That's how we progressively worship God today. Because the world, as a Laodicea is, has become so corrupt. It affects even the disciplines of our family. Okay, so I'm gonna ask everyone to read. I'm gonna ask one person to read. So right now, ask them to read. So, Nico, could you read Proverbs 29:15? Bernice, maybe you memorize it. A child left to himself. The rod and reproof give wisdom. But child left to himself bringeth his mother to shame. Ask them to read it. Read it here. Now, what does that mean? Do you understand that revelation? Do you have that revelation? You do not leave a child by himself. He's just playing around. He's a child. Why should you bother them playing around? Because eventually their innocence will be gone and they will become corrupt. What should you be doing on the vacant time of your child? And that's where the revelation of offensiveness comes in. You should offensively train them in the ways of the Lord, that when he is old, he will not depart from it. So you should not give idle time to your children, to leave them by themselves. You should teach them first. What things could you not just teach? You should command them. What things could you command your children so that they will know the ways of the Lord? You teach them to pray. You teach them house chores. You give them house chores. And after house chores, there's still vacant time. You teach them to advance their academics. If their academics are advanced, they could skip ordinary school and be accelerated to a higher level. And they will be spared from the corruption in regular school. Then, divide the spare time from academic, because we're not carnal people, we're spiritual people. The other half should be devoted to study, spiritual study. The other half should be devoted to transcribing messages, spiritual messages. There's lots of tapes. The prophets have thousands of tapes, messages, sermons. Even other ministers also have that. We also have that. Do not waste your time letting them watch cartoons, telenovelas. Do not let them waste their time playing around with a cell phone. Games or selfies or whatever. Paul said, redeem the time. So you should be redeeming the time. Do not act as if you're already in the millennium. As if the devil does not exist. The message of the prophet Satan to Eden. It's precisely that. How many of you have read that? Raise your hand. Satan's Eden. Did Brother Branham say Satan's Eden is like being in the garden thinking there's no devil, like everything is perfect? Did he explain it that way, Brother Menan? How did he explain it, Satan's Eden? How? You forgot what you read? Of course, not the exact words. What is the exact words he said? Or the thought. What is the exact thought that he was saying? What is his intention?
Something like that.
Not the exact word. The thought. If you are contented, if you do not redeem the time, you are in Satan's Eden. You don't have to be in the garden back there when Adam and they lowered their guard so that the serpent could come in. Right now, the serpent is coming into your life. Daily work, studies, and entertainment. How many of you still have worldly entertainment? Raise your hand. Just say amen, if you're asking to raise your hand. How many have? Say amen. Now, if you are not matured in the Word of God, those worldly entertainment will poison you. You will only have immunity. When I say immunity, when you see entertainment, you always think of God and you get even a message from them. But if you're still immature, your children are immature. Those entertainment, will close their mind from lukewarmness to Nicolaitanism. What is Nicolaitanism? Nicolaitanism is when you command them to do something, they don't want to do it because it's spiritual. It's against the devil possessing their flesh. And if you do not want to assert by the rod, you let the devil prevail. Eventually, they will grow up disobedient. Have you seen young people very disobedient? Have you seen? How many have seen? Say amen. Those were left to themselves. Proverbs 29:15. So, okay, that's communion. So, did you say communion? Okay. So, you see, we have many communion messages. We're not going to open each and every one of them, but I'm going to ask you to do that after we leave. Ask for a copy of the track. Get the copy online in Facebook. Ask Brother Jose how to open the track. Where's the song? Could you give me some song? Where's the button? Okay. So, please arrange this. Could you read this? Where's the eraser? I'm going to erase it myself. No eraser? Okay. So, how many of you have communion tracts? How many? Raise your hand. Those here, how many of you have this communion tracts in your possession? How many? Raise your hand. Sister? No more? How about the rest? Don't you have a personal copy of yours? Brother David, you don't have a personal copy? Brother Jonas? Brother, okay, if you don't have, get a copy. Well, since I'm recording, I still have to say, you have to just take note. I just have to introduce what are the messages of communion cup we have made. These messages are revelations from the scripture. Some of them coincide also from what the prophet said. So, each and every one of you should give devotional time to study them. Okay? Although not everything will be studied there, at least you're going to get an idea what is real communion with the Lord. A while ago I said, commune is to sup. Another meaning of commune is to fellowship. So, in the world, there are many fellowships, but worshipping other things. They have a drinking day, they enjoy certain things, worshipping. But for the Lord, communing is also fellowshipping, it's also worshipping Him. Worship means you give priority, worship. It is worth to God, priority, one another. Now, the word commune, this is where communism got their name. But of course, when communism used that word, they meant to say what happened in the book of Acts. The disciples contributed all their finances, their property for one common goal, to help each other. So the original goal of communism was ideal. But of course it's on the aspect of flesh. But communing in the Lord means first we have fellowship with the Lord and we have fellowship with each other. We fellowship with each other for the Lord, we strengthen each other. So communion, spiritual communion, means fellowshipping with one another in the Lord. Now, we conducted physical communion, and you should conduct them in your home at night. Can you say? Okay, how many minutes have I had? Okay, so later I still have Tagalog question answer. So, okay, so you can open up whenever I say the year, okay? So, communion with the Lord and with each other is the right way of worshiping God. How? When you commune together, not only in service, but services. Even in break time, even after the cell grouping, whenever we're eating, when we talk to each other, what are you talking about? If there's no more urgency, you can talk about other things. But if there's urgency, you prioritize admonishing, reckoning. Kinukumusta. You visit them by visitation, by asking them their spiritual life. Then you advise them what they should do at home. You should do that to each other. That's 3% of the life. Exhorting one another. You don't exhort one another only on church services. Worship services. You exhort one another when you talk to each other. So that's an expanded view, a progressive view of Hebrews 10:25. When you gather together, it's not just this morning service. Whenever you come together, you talk about Him. Let's talk about Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
So, let's walk the talk and talk the walk. That means to say, let's do it. Let's talk about Jesus later. Now, even after our cell grouping, you know, last night there were young people here, even after everyone else had left, they continued sharing the word. They were so hungry for the word of God, they asked each other for that revelation. I experienced the blues when I was young. So, if you feel the fire of God, you should do that. So just ask questions. There are lots of revelations from God and instructions. You'll never run out of it. And yet you waste your time talking about earthly things. If it's not of necessity, prioritize Him. Then you can enjoy these well other things than you said that God created. But that's secondary. It's already mature. That's not the primary. Okay. Let's give the date. The first communion sacrament was the Lord's Supper. The Lord's Supper, if you can pack that there, like yesterday it was blown up. It just reduced the size, everyone can see it. If you have a copy, it's this. Look at your copy if you have a copy. Okay? The Lord's Supper is like an introduction to all other tracts. Because it talks about the original way with scripture, how to conduct the Lord's Supper, communion. Then it gives the reason why. So there's a traditional evolution from that, and there's the original way that we should come back, restore back to the Lord, back to the original way the apostles did. Then, what does it mean? What is the significance? You should know that. Christ died for that, died for your souls, by the Holy Spirit, and you're living your life here, you should know your purpose on earth. He has his purpose on earth. Do not lose your purpose. So, the Lord's Supper, if you look at this part of the adoration talks about the meaning why. Why do you come together? Why is it not considered a burden taking a sick? Why is it a family gathering? Why? Why should it be unleavened? Why should it be red grape wine? Why? What does it represent on that you should do it on spring? On the day of the days of the Passover, in the days of the unleavened bread. Why? What does it represent? So you should study that. Now let's go to other communion tracts. We have the next communion tract is 2006. I think I'm 5 minutes. I can take it up. 2000 talks about. If you can track that. If you have a copy, it's at the back of your tract. It talks about the birthday. Spring is the birthday when Christ died. When Christ died, that's how he will be born. Born again from the ground. Are we born again? If we're born again, it's not yet from the ground. It's not yet finished. It could be aborted. The complete born again experience is resurrection from the dead. As Christ was said to be the firstborn from the dead. So Communion 2006 also advises, so short, but you can know the details. How you should celebrate your birthday? Birthdays are supposed to be funeral services. Why? Because you're celebrating death, Christ was born to die. If you celebrate your birthday in ignorance, you're celebrating your ignorance. But if you have revelation, that's supposed to be your funeral service. Because your real birthday is the date of the communion, when Christ rose from the dead. See, alongside with him, the Old Testament saints rose with him. So we will rise with him. Communion 2008. How many of you have copies of that? Last 2008 there. 2008 has been reported by some sister, but of course, I hope you could share it to each and everyone. Do you have a copy there? Okay, oh, there is the copy. Just look up there. Look at the projector. Lift it up. Let's see some illustrations of people having children. 2008 talks about the resurrection from the dead. Spiritually, by the word, if you gather together regularly, could you raise the track so the illustration could be seen? Could you raise it up? Okay. So, there's a drawing how cell groups should be done. And also in the church, what is the effect of a church service where there is no cell group and everyone sharing the word compared to those just hearing the word from the pulpit? Okay, 2009 talks about, I said it to Sister Sinelli, asked it from her, what is the feeling of the First Communion? There were Moses and the rest of the Israelites were scared to death because all the children in Egypt, the firstborn, were being killed by the angel of death. And they're so afraid that their own children will be killed by the angel of death. But they will be saved if they put the blood of the lamb in the doorpost. The angel of death will pass over, that's where Passover comes from. Pass over them. But how did the angel of death pass over them? Because they fulfilled, they obeyed the commandment of the Lord to have communion in their home. And they were commanded to do it. While they were doing it, they were so afraid. Right now, we don't have any fear of the Lord. So Communion 2009 also talks about the tribulation period. So if you could flash it there, Most of it are scriptures talking about how Egypt was bombarded with fire, bombarded with plagues, just as it will happen on earth. Scriptures. Communion 2010, so we'll flash it. Talks about the sacred meal. When we partake our ordinary meals, In the book of Acts, if you could open up Acts chapter 2, ask yourself to read it for you. Acts chapter 2, verse 42 to 45. I'm not going to read it, you ask yourself to read it for you. For the exam mat, you have to put your arm with your adopted child. Ask them to read, brother. Ask brother Gaboy, not to command him to read for you. Not aloud, but by whisper. Ask them to read in your ear. Ask them to look where the word comes, where the part they did, house to house. They daily, the word daily, ask them to mark it for you. So after they read it for you, ask them to mark the word daily. That is to say, communion penitent talked about breaking of bread. That kind of bread is not a physical, literal, unleavened bread. That breaking of bread is a literal meal, ordinary meal every day of our life. When you partake of your meal, it's also fellowship. Our old parents, they require us to be present in the table. So, that ordinary meal, they requiring the, all the family members to be present. The kind of discipline, of course, is not just a tradition, but for us, by revelation, it's a sacred meal. Why is it sacred? Because you talk about the Word of God. So, sacred meal is not just the unleavened bread. Even your ordinary meal, that could become sacred if you have sharing at home in front of the table of family meals, lunch, dinner, you talk about God, it becomes sacred meal. And when you visit other houses, that's also sacred meal. Because, of course, the host will give out some snacks. Let's go to Communion 20, this is not 2011, right? 2012. Communion 2012, so you can pass it in your screen. Communion 2012 talks about you go to other houses, you bring bread and wine, like Melchizedek did. If you bring bread and wine, it represents the word and stimulation for revelation. Just like the Samaritan put wine, oil and wine, to the wounded half dead Jew. So, we visit other brethren to strengthen each other. And that's also communion when our president brought bread and wine to Abraham. Next, it is communion. All the rest of the years are so far away from you. What's the next one? Communion. Huh? 2013? I don't know that. What is the subject? Intervention? Transubstantiation. Okay. So, Communion 2013 is about transubstantiation. I'm not gonna discuss it here. My time is running out. Let's move to the next year. 2014. What does it talk about? Intervention. So, you have to ask about it. You have to know about it. You have to hunger for it. Ask your children to search about it. You ask the parents about it. Ask Pastor Jose about it. What is it all about? Okay? Communion 20, next, 16, what does it talk about? Personal devotional time, yes. Right to dividing the truth. So, personal communion with God. The first verse I gave you today, I will come to him and he is me. Stop with him. Communion 2017, Brother Menan. What is the subject? Huh? Where God has planned. So he will just explain to you later. Similar remembrance of me. Does it include or just 2018? So what is 2017? There's none. What are what item? God has fallen. So it has something to do with our backsliding and returning to God. 2018. Do this in remembrance of me. When we do the communion, we are remembering what we should be doing for the rest of our lives, for the rest of the year. It's a reset button for us to be refreshed. So let's talk about this in our cell group. Okay, oh, could you please inject the the charger. Inject the charger. Okay, stop the video. Stop the English video.